today, we're going to release some documents. Joyce TCAP. First up, I would like to release the actual paperwork filed in the circuit court, the 20th Circuit Court in and for Charlotte County, Florida.
Thanks, David. It's actually DeSoto County, Florida this time. But they released the police report today, so I'll read it to you. And it reads, on July 17th, 2022, Deputy Bigsby responded to an address on Northeast Highway 70 in regards to a burglary. Deputy Bigsby spoke to the person who leases the above property. On the property is a barn, and to the rear is a camper. This person was informed by housekeeping that they noticed the television set was on and the screen to the back room was closed of the camper. They also advised him that there were bowls of food on the table. On the scene, the deputies and the housekeeper noticed that there was damage to the door and the locks. The damage was consistent with broken locks and the door was bent near the locking mechanism. The bottom of the door appeared to be split in half due to it being kicked in forcefully as well. The owner of the camper estimated the approximate damage of being $1,000 per camper door. The owner of the camper, a different person, was contacted and he confirmed that no one is allowed to be in the camper and no one resides in it. At the time of the call for service, no one was inside the residence as it was cleared by the deputies. The owner was advised of the incident and had stated he has a green cup on top of the refrigerator that contained approximately $300. The denominations of the money was unknown, but he stated it was coins and bills. Deputies noted that the money was missing. Deputy Bigsby seized several items from inside the camper. All of the following items were seized for evidence, as they did not belong to the victims. A Walmart receipt for a Coke and Marlboro cigarettes totaling $11.06, dated July 14th, 2022, at 20:25 hours. A white paper napkin with possible blood transfer. A pair of black Nike size 11 Air sneakers and fingerprints obtained on scene. On July 18th, 2022, I, which is Detective Rodrigo Santiago, was assigned this case for further investigation. I went to the Walmart Supercenter in Arcadia, Florida, and inquired about the purchase of the Coke and Marlboro cigarettes per the receipt. With the provided date and time, I observed on video surveillance a white male wearing camouflage clothing with a black hat with the Miami Heat logo, a red basketball with a white ring, purchasing one Coke and a pack of cigarettes. The male also had a full beard, and as the subject was being checked out by the cashier, I observed that he laid down several coins and began counting them to pay for his items. It should be noted that coins were stolen from the camper. Later that day, a subject matching the description from the Walmart footage was located at the Speedway convenience store. So what had happened was, this is not in the police report, but what happened was the police took that surveillance video and posted it online. I'm still waiting for that, but they posted that video online and somebody must have saw David at the convenience store and called the police. I responded to the Speedway and I observed a male subject who was sitting down and I was able to verify it was the subject who made the purchase at the Walmart wearing the black Miami Heat hat. Along with the hat, he was wearing camo overalls and a flowered patterned green shirt with white socks and sandals. The male was identified by Florida identification as David Schumacher from Punta Gorda, Florida. I advised David of his Miranda warning and he waived his rights and agreed to speak with me. David informed me that he was from Punta Gorda and that he was homeless at the time and staying in Arcadia. I told David that I knew he was staying in a camper at a property on Highway 70, as a receipt for his purchases was located inside the camper. David responded with, "I don't have any information." David was shown a picture of him leaving the Walmart with the purchased items, and once again he stated, "I don't have any information." As I kept questioning David about the camper, he kept saying, "I don't have any information," and refused to divulge any more information to law enforcement. Based on the above information, David was arrested and transported to the DeSoto County Jail without incident. I followed up with the owner of the camper and advised him of the arrest and forwarded him a picture of the suspect's clothing. He called me and informed me that the suspect was wearing his camouflage overall pants, which he estimated to be approximately $150. David, he also advised that the green flowered shirt the suspect was wearing was his own. He said that the shirt was made by his mother, who is now deceased, and it was priceless. He informed me that the shirt would have a tag that says mom. The shirt was seized for evidence, and I confirmed it did say mom on the back. Based on the above facts and circumstances, David Schumacher was arrested pursuant to Florida State Statute 810.023B, burglary of an unoccupied dwelling. Also, grand theft from a dwelling of more than $100, but less than $700, which is the $300 worth of money stolen, and the overall pants at $150. And criminal mischief, more than $1,000, and that's being the two broken camper doors valued at $1,000 each. That's all we got so far. Talk to you guys later.
What? And then you stand there and sit there in judgment. Read the Constitution, bro.